please welcome Corporate Executive Officer, Corporate Vice President, COO in charge of Solution Services, and Head of Global Solutions at Fujitsu, Yoshinami Takahashi.
Hi, everyone. My name is Takahashi from Fujitsu. Basically, I want to talk about what we do with Palantir in Japan. Not only in Japan, but also like across the globe, we work with Palantir trying to provide transformation to all the necessary countries. So Fujitsu is a Japanese, one of the largest tech company. We focus, we build like a supercomputer, a quantum computing, not air conditioning, by the way. we're like a big, one of the largest system integrator. We focus on the mission critical, either it may be healthcare, like a finance, but this is very important. So through our global brand called Fujitsu Uvance, we're committed to kind of solve the society issues. And again, turning data and AI into better decisions and real world outcomes. This is very important. So again, with Palantir, we focus on the mission critical. Again, very critical to Japanese competitiveness. So we focus again in like enterprise customers, but like manufacturing, automotive, energy, and also like healthcare. And these are really important. So many of these sectors do face a lot of challenges, not only unique to Japan, but I'm sure all these multinational companies outside of Japan do face similar kind of problems. Like in Japan, by 2045, there's like a reduction of labor force by almost 30%. That's a big number. So we're gonna face shortage of labor. As you know, we have an earthquake in Japan. So that's pretty immense, what's happening in the earthquake. All the geopolitical issues that's happening across the globe, that's another issue. So in this kind of uncertainty, we are leveraging Palantir's technology and also Fujitsu's technology to kind of mitigate all the risk. Also one more point is very important. We've been using Palantir for almost 5 years. So we have like a 60 siloed system in Fujitsu. So we all integrated the data through ontology, making sure we can make a right decision, a global decision, making a right decision for business. So this type of practice, internal practice, we take to our customer as a first-hand experience. This is very important. So last year in 2024 AIPCon, my colleague has talked about like the supply chain. So this year we have moved this dynamic supply chain management operating system using embedded AI more into like an advanced level. So what I want to show you today is a live demonstration of what we have right now and also what is coming up with the new AI agents. So this is kind of a typical example of like a Japanese global manufacturer. They have like a 3,000 suppliers, 18 factories, scattered system around 20. So they have obviously issue around data's fragmentation. 200,000 SKU. So basically the company was struggling with the inventory management. So what we did is basically in 2 weeks with Palantir, without shutting down the existing system, we built this global supply chain system and also made the data into visible so that the company can engage into the transformation. So now they almost manage 2 million parts simultaneously. With Palantir Foundry, with our AI platform, Kozuchi, again, auto machine learning, we built a connected supply chain system with 30 integrated applications across inventory, forecasting, and production and planning. So in just 2 months, Kozuchi is, again, auto machine learning. We built 300 demand prediction for 300 SKUs. Because of this, the company was able to reduce the labor force by 50%. And now they have this annual cost saving of over $10 million. So how is this basically possible? Is again, this we did not base it on a single application, not a dashboard, but also like this is like a truly integrated dynamic supply chain management operating system. Again, we think solving this kind of impact in society, in resolving these social issues, but also business issue is very important. So let me kind of show you how this is placed in action. So when we talk about the dynamic supply chain management operating system, we do not mean just like a visibility. It's about how much the company can take quick actions. making or like taking every decisions in a right timing, address the risk before it happens across like a production logistics and customer and consumers. Again, the inventory control. Many of the large Japanese companies still use spreadsheet, which is again an issue. So with this operating system, the entire process is automated. All the supply chain data flows into one connected environment, optimizing operations, cutting costs, and also maintaining resilience. This is kind of very important. And today, this automation is evolving further with AI agents. When a shortage risk appears, specialized agent for procurement, inventory, and sales, each will be proposing a solution. An orchestration agent will kind of select the best option, and an evaluator agent will validate the option. Then the human beings, upon necessity, they will make decision collaboratively with the AI agent. So again, we think dynamic supply chain, like more than 95% of the task should be automated. So this is not really in theory, but it's in practice right now with the Japanese large companies right now in Japan. This capability and speed are only possible because it's not a single application, but a fabric of over 30 interconnected applications built on the same business ontology. Once the ontology allows every new application to reinforce for the others, accelerating development and creating a shared foundation where AI agents and human operators collaborate seamlessly. And the result is not just efficiency, but also the resilience. So as I kind of mentioned before, like Japan is like a country of earthquake. So when Noto earthquake hit in January of 2024, this company was able to kind of mitigate all the risks associated with supply chain. So within like one day, they were able to kind of define what is the possible impact. And they made a decision to reroute, kind of change supply on the spot. Usually it took like almost like 4 to 7 days. But through this kind of ontology data integration and leveraging the AI, they were able to do this type of crisis management. So again, the true supply chain, we think it's like it needs to be like a connected, intelligent, and ready for both daily decisions and crisis response. So building on that same foundation, we are now taking it to the next level, embedding AI agents directly into disaster response. The reality is that this operating system not only works in the business as usual, this is not enough. So in the modern global supply chain, we believe it needs to withstand a variety of shocks. So again, earthquakes, or like a tsunami, or like a supplier failure, or even like a geopolitical disruption that can break all the continuity with the business. So together with Palantir, we developed these agents to handle these complex scenarios. For example, a disaster response agent for large-scale earthquakes in Japan, where like a magnitude 8 is expected in the next few decades, we have to be kind of prepared for this type of incidents. So this agent will be managing disruption, simulating potential facility damage, assessing inventory impact, and also highlighting weak points across the supply chain. So again, supporting not the day-to-day usage only, but at the time of crisis, how fast we can respond to this type of incidents. This is very important. Another point is, again, because our ontology, AIP and AI agents are unified on one platform, the agent not only explains why they have made that options, but also turns this into the live execution, moving operators from insight to actions instantly with confidence. This is very important. So again, one example around this is the like a principle applies not only across like a single task, but like a procurement, production, sales, and connectivity of AI agents embedded directly into the operation. So as I have mentioned, the AI agent will be developed and is going to learn how to mitigate more risk in a more clever way. We think this is very important moving forward. So then the next step is going to be, how do we train and evolve the AI agents? So this is kind of a very famous icon that we have made. So we have this very domain-specific agents working across multiple tasks. So the rapid development of AI agent not is possible, but practical at scale. This is very important. So each time the agents face a disruption or an unusual case, they learn from the feedback from human beings. And then, based on their proposal, the human beings will be feeding back. Was that the right decision? Was that an effective decision? And also, validation agent will be teaching all the domain-specific agent, you could have maybe made a different decision or option. So I think this type of enterprise feedback loop with the data and interaction between human beings, that will be kind of educating all the agents. Again, auto machine learning, this type of technology will also support the agents learn quickly about the incidents. So more and more, we think the agent itself is going to be automated as we kind of leverage this type of agents across multiple cases. So one of the key elements is that the AI agent is going to grow from like a newborn to a very skilled professionals over time. So again, they do not learn like a task by the explicit rules, but also by subtle decision-making that is unique to each company. And because this capability is embedded in the operating system, it scales, allowing organizations to continuously advance their dynamic supply chain shared by their own expertise. So this type of like the agent learning from each other, being educated as a skilled worker, we think there's going to be a rapid development of AI agents in this segment. Our vision with Palantir goes beyond this single case. We think this AI agent is going to reside in a single usage for a moment, like within a company. But over time, the agent will talk to each other with a cross-company, and that will kind of give more impact, resolving many of the society issues. Again, imagine one of the manufacturers with all the suppliers sharing data. They can all basically manage the disruption in a more managed way. Imagine this agent is talking into cross-industry for like an energy company. How to kind of ensure that the electricity is provided to the needed factory. So when the data is shared, we think we can provide much more biggest resilience to the society itself. So our vision is to kind of leverage technology, again, Palantir and Fujitsu coming together to kind of make sure we have a very robust system in the Japan society. But we basically want to kind of provide this type of solution across the, not only in Japan, but also across the global market. So that is my presentation today, and thank you very much for the attention. Thank you so much.